Hello everyone and welcome back to Dynamix Academy. This is our Microsoft Dynamics 365 CRM interview questions and answers video series. So in this video we will see request from Sriram. So he has posted these 5 questions that he wants us to answer them. So Sriram, this video is for you. We highly appreciate the fact that you have taken some time to view our channel as well as post some of the interesting questions, and I'm sure after looking at these 5 questions, every Dynamics 365 developer or technical person might have faced these questions in his or her career. So the first question he has asked is, if a plugin fails in production but not in development region, then how we can fix the issue? Another question he has asked is there any difference in debugging of asynchronous and synchronous plugins? Third question he has asked is, if pre-validation step fails, will it stop the whole transaction? Fourth question he has asked is, if a production has all unmanaged solution, how to convert all unmanaged to managed solution? And lastly, he has asked, in production with managed solution, if you want to update or delete an entity, assembly or a process, how we can achieve this? And also, if you want to update the data type of a field from string to option set, how can we do that? So the fifth question is a bit larger one, and he has posted multiple questions in the last question. And so as far as this video is concerned, we will only look at the first question, and all other questions we will cover in our upcoming videos, because if I answer these 5 questions in one video, then this video will get too longer. So in this video, we will see the solution of our first question that he has posted. If a plugin fails in production environment but not in development region, then how to fix the issue or how to debug that? I personally have faced this kind of issues in my career. So whenever you land up in this kind of situation, you need to observe the plugin behavior carefully in your production environment. So the very first thing that you need to do in order to fix the issue is to analyze the issue. You need to first find out the root cause of that, why the plugin is failing. Based on my experience, one of the following two situations might occur in production environment. The number one situation is that plugin does not throw any error, but at the same time it is not performing its required job. So that can be one scenario. After registering the plugin is not throwing an error, but at the same time it is not doing the required job. And sometimes the plugin directly throws an error the moment you take that action on the production environment. So one of these two things will happen. Either the plugin does not throw any error, but it does not perform any required action. And the second case might be the plugin directly will throw the error upfront the moment you perform that action on the production environment. So we will step by step see what are the different situations this kind of issues occur, plugin fails on production environment in both the cases, and we'll try to see the possible corrective actions as well for all these kind of situations. So whenever the plugin is not throwing an error and it's not performing its required job, then the possible causes for that issue is either the plugin itself is not triggering. So if plugin is not triggering, that means it is not performing its job. So if it is not triggering, so we need to identify why it's not triggering. The next case might be plugin is triggering, but somewhere within your code you have placed the null checks, right? You are retrying a set of collections and you have placed the null checks in your code, and there is no such data created in a production environment. Because of that, the whatever the things that you are retrying in your custom code, and because of the null check conditions placed, the plugin is not performing the required job. Another most common case is where plugin is triggering, but due to the validation in depth condition, which is one of the most commonly placed condition in every plugin. Plugin depth condition is not handled properly, so the plugin is moving out of it before performing its required job. So generally, this kind of error occurs due to misconfiguration, or whenever you are checking the conditions and you are trying to skip some part of the code due to null checks or depth conditions, then plugin will not throw any error, but still it will not perform its required job. And if the plugin is throwing error, then these might be some of the situations where the plugin is failing on production environment. So first of all, you have to observe the error, and sometimes the error itself will identify the misconfiguration. So it will show you that specific so and so configuration is missing, and the plugin message itself is obvious. You can simply say that it is a misconfiguration error. For example, if you have not created any required post or pre-images, and you, in your code you are utilizing those post and pre-images, then the error message will read out clearly that a required entity message is missing. Another type of situation where plugin will throw error is whenever the required customizations or the permissions are not present in the production or any other environment apart from development region. So sometimes the error might be due to the customizations that you are reading in your code are not found on production environment. And sometimes user's context the plugin is running is not having sufficient privileges on production environment. In those situations, plugin will throw an error. Third kind of situation where plugin will throw error on production environment is if you are directly reading first or default condition whenever you are retrying or working with entity collection in code, and you are directly using the first or default method, because this is a general tendency of developers that they know that the records will be present and they will directly read first or default from the retrieved entity collection. But the data or the entity records that they are retrieving does not return any values. This is also the plugin might throw errors. Other kind of situation is that whenever you're trying to retrieve a configuration record and those records are still not created in the production region, then those retrieve line of code will fail in your plugin. So whenever the plugin is throwing error, so generally it is a code logic or some erroneous code has been written in the plugin. So in this kind of situation, your plugin might fail. So let us now see the possible solutions for both the cases. So if the plugin is not throwing an error, but still it's not performing any required job, then the first situation might be plugin itself is not triggering. So in this case, if you are writing the trace logs, so you can enable the tracing and start checking if the plugin is triggering itself or not. So if you have found out that plugin itself is not triggering, then you need to check the plugin configuration on production region. First, you need to check the message for which the plugin is being written. If any filtering attributes in case of update message are required to be set, then you need to re-verify on the production region that the filtering attributes and message and entity for which this plugin is written are correctly configured. And sometimes you need to verify that run in the user context field is set differently on development region, and if it is not set on production region correctly, then this can be a failure cause as well. And sometimes the plugin stage is not configured properly, synchronous or asynchronous. And sometimes secure and unsecure configurations that you are utilizing in your plugin are not created on the production environment, especially in case of secure configuration. Because if you are moving the plugins on production environment with the help of solution, and in your plugin code you are utilizing some of the secure configurations, then Secure configuration will not directly move from one region to another region whenever you are moving it through plugin solutions. So secure configuration has to be reconfigured manually on each and every environment that you are registering the plugin with. So that can be another cause of failure as well. And you need to verify that if any post or pre-images and the required attributes are set correctly on production region. And especially if you're registering the plugins manually, then you need to make sure the name and the name of the post and pre-images are correct for the development region and the code. So these are the possible solutions in order to make sure that plugin is triggering. The next situations where plugin does not throw any error but still it does not do the required job is the plugin might be triggering but it might be moving out of the null check conditions within your code. So for example, if you are retrieving some of huge entity list of collection and after that you are placing the null checks, if the entity collections dot entities dot count is greater than zero, then only execute remaining line of code. So in these situations the plugin might be moving out of that condition. In these situations, you need to create the required data. You need to make sure that whatever the entity collections that you are trying to retrieve are at least having one record present in your production environment. Next thing is, plugin is triggering, but still, due to depth condition validation in your plugin, it is moving out of it. So this is also another common reason why the plugin will fail on production environment. In your code, you are verifying if the context.depth is greater than 1, then you are returning from the very first few line of code in your plugin. Then consider a scenario where, for example, you have written a plugin on create of an account and you have another plugin on create of contact, and in that second plugin you are again creating an account and record, then it will again trigger the account creation plugin and the depth of that account creation plugin will be 2. So in this kind of scenarios, plugin will never enter into the required code. So you have to be careful while validating the depth property of the context. So a general conclusion can be drawn out that whenever a plugin does not throw any error but still it does not perform its required job on the production region, then 99% it would be configuration error, or somewhere within your code you are placing some null checks and the conditions are not met due to which the plugin is not performing its job. So analyze your code thoroughly and make sure that all the required configuration and null check conditions are handled properly and all the required data are created on the production region. So let us now see the possible solutions whenever the plugin is throwing error only on the production region but those kind of errors are not found on development region. So in this scenario, observe the error. Sometimes the error itself will tell you that what are the required configuration that are missing. Make sure that all the secure and unsecured configurations are present on the production region, because if you are moving the solution from dev to production region and within your code if you are using some secure configurations, then while importing the solution on production environment, by default those secure configurations will not move. So you have to again reconfigure them. So that one thing, that is the thing that you need to manually again verify it. And if you are using some post and pre-images and if you are configuring it manually again on the production region, then make sure that all required entity images are present with the correct name and all the required attributes are created. Another situations where the plugin might fail with an error is that if required customizations and permissions are not present on the production or the higher environment apart from development region. For example, so first of all you need to make sure that all the customizations or the new fields or required fields that you are utilizing in your plugin code are present on the production region. Another common scenario where the plugin might throw error is permissions error. So in this case, if the permissions are not found, then it will throw an insufficient privileges error. And with the help of that error message, you can make out that there are some permissions that are not found. So the user's context in which that plugin is running is not having that specific set of privileges. So you need to make sure that the required permissions and customizations are present on production environment. Third scenario where that sometimes developer directly read the first or default entity from whenever he is retrying or working with entity collection in the code, then if the whatever the entity collection he is trying to retry from the code, that data itself is not present on the production region, then it will throw an error. You can follow one of the two solutions, which is you first create the required record for all the required entities or attributes that you are retrieving in the plugin, or you must place a null check within your code. And sometimes if you are reading some configuration entity records and that records are not yet created in the production environment, then again the plugin will fail with an error message. So in this situation also you need to create the required data, or you can place the null check after retrieving the records. So in this case, the general conclusion can be drawn out that if the plugin is failing with an error message, that means there is some issue with your code logic or erroneous code has been written. And lastly, after making sure all these conditions within your plugin, and still if you are not able to fix the issue, then my suggestion would be you need to first understand the environment or the users who are facing this issue. Sometimes the issue might be user specific, sometimes the issue might be the machine specific, and sometimes if everything is failing, you need to after registering the plugin, you have to refresh, and if it is on premise, you can perform an IIS reset as well, and after that you can start debugging a plugin outside the business hours and try to understand what is the thing that is failing. So on that note, I hope that I have tried to cover the maximum dimensions or the maximum scenarios that I personally feel and faced in my career. And if you are still not able to debug or fix the issue on production environment, please put them in the comment section and we'll try to understand the scenario, as well as we'll try to come up with an answer as well. So on that note, I will end this lecture, and I hope to see you all in our upcoming lectures and upcoming videos as well. Please feel free to put down all your questions, queries, feedbacks in the comment section below. And if you like this video, please do share and subscribe to Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. Bye bye and take care.